I love the finish. And
yeah. Interesting fellow. Yeah, that's it.
Uh-oh. Well, we don't have a connection for.
Well, that's good.
We have this.
All right, cool. Introduce yourself, man. Tell us something about yourself.
I know what you mean.
All right.
Mild mannered.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Michael.
Basically, my name's Mike, and I'm from Glendale, California. Born and raised, so Glendale's always going to be home for me. Both of my folks are from the Philippines. Basically, just grew up most of my life in public school. And I graduated last year going to a place called AFCO up north. So kind of like a place called Amazing Facts, which is kind of a place where I'm learning some how to give Bible studies and stuff. And went out and did Bible work over in Chicago for about 8 months. And I've been back ever since, since April. Never felt more at home in all my life after spending a Chicago winter over there. So, I just can say I've never felt so much more at home in all my life. Thanks to Daniel Este for bringing me here. Tonight I'll be sharing with you a song, and it's called Look and Live.
Whoa. Do we have a stand?
He's got it. We got you covered, buddy. Nice stuff.
I know.
Who
told Eugene about this?
We know what we're doing.
Yeah, sure.
You would have maybe looked at that. How about Sam? Sam does stuff, doesn't he?
Huh?
Who does Sam do? Does he sing?
Nah.
Does he play an instrument?
Alright, then. Alright. So did you write, is it an original song?
Yeah.
Ah. Right.
It's called Look and Live. Yeah, this is coming straight out of Chicago. So while I was there, just messing around.
Is there a backstory to this song?
Look and Live, it's kind of like, it has a lot to do with my own personal testimony, you know, dragging out how I really felt about myself at the moment and stuff. So it's called Look and Live.
I read about the God.
died on the cross and took all of our shame, so you and I can survive. Now I'm here on my knees, with a heart willing to believe. Help me, Lord, to see your love, and to not turn away when I see your son. To behold your loving kindness so strong. Help me, Lord, to see your love, and to not turn away when I see the cross. To behold your righteous mercies from above. I don't understand your loving kindness, goodness and patience so free. I'd give up on myself a long time ago, but you're still right here with me. Now I'm here on my knees, with a heart willing to believe. Help me, Lord, to see your love, and to not turn away when I see your son. To behold your loving kindness so strong. Help me, Lord, to see your love, and to not turn away when I see the cross. To behold your righteous mercies from above. Help me, Lord, to see your love, and to not turn away when I see your son. Your son. Your son. Your son. Your son. Basically, the backstory with this is I went on a few mission trips to the Philippines. I went to the Philippines a few times for some mission trips. I went on a share hymn when I was 16. And basically, I remember growing up, going to Philippines for reunions and vacations as a kid. Absolutely hated it. I was completely culture shocked, never wanted to go back. Because my family, they grew up in like the poor areas. And that's just not a very fun place to be. But when I went there on my first mission trip, I can definitely say that ever since then, I really don't know how to explain, but I just kind of fell in love with the place. I fell in love with the people. And even though I went through some more stuff later on, you know, there's just no denying that I really loved my time in the Philippines. So this is called Breaking Talk.
Steps as he walks away. Jesus is to have a heart of eyes. It really doesn't make a difference who or what and where you are. Cause the way to break the heart of Jesus is to have a heart of eyes. Yeah. Children with nothing to eat, and wear the same clothes every day. The favorite toys they play with, the ones on their feet. 1 million the world over turn their eyes away and see the look of sadness all over Jesus' face, and the heaviness in his footsteps as he walks away. The way to break the heart of Jesus is to have a hardened heart. The way to break the heart of Jesus is to have a hardened heart. Jesus is to have a hardened heart, yeah. Have you ever had somebody try to sympathize with you, but clearly they don't know what you're going through? All they do is stand there telling you what to do, but won't lend a loving hand to help along the way. And see the look of sadness all over Jesus' face, and the heaviness in his footsteps as he walks away. The way to break the heart of Jesus is to have a hardened heart. It really doesn't make a difference who or what or where you are. Cause the way to break the heart of Jesus is to have a hardened heart. Yeah.
Sing today.